project's called 300 Asterisk. It's a bowling movie. When I was younger, in high school, I used to go bowling with my friend and his dad. Something that a lot of people take for granted, like bowling is not a sport, or just being like a time to get together with your friends, that two people can actually appreciate it and it can bring them together. And I really love the idea of that. I think that the main character is very much me. He's very quiet and reserved, but he wants to burst out of the shell.
James is pretty precise. He's a pretty precise character. And I try to bring some precision to that. And I think at my core, I'm kind of a type A. I like things to be neat and clean and orderly and in the right place. But at the same time, look at my car, and it's pretty messy. So there's a part of me that's pretty precise. And I think that part of me I'm trying to bring out more for the character of James, because I think that's who he is.
The girlfriend character is an amalgamation of both the perfect girl and past experiences I've had with projects. We were getting our groups together, and Spencer approached me and he said, "Do you want a DP?" And I said, "I would love a DP." And he said, "Done."
I told everybody that I want to spend a lot of money and rent an expensive camera package and shoot film.
We're the only group risking, you know, our necks and our pocketbooks by shooting films.
But I think that all boils down to the look of the film and how it'll look, and hopefully it will look different from some of the stuff that's happening. And the script was good.
There's kind of an A story and a B story, and the A story is a son who's trying to finish his father's perfect bowling game, which is a neat story in and of itself. But there's a B story where my character James has a love interest who recently revealed to him that she has a son that he didn't know about, and the two storylines kind of come together at the same point. And I think the story has a really nice arc in a pretty short amount of time.
My favorite moment of the shoot, bar none, the shot where from behind and the actor is bowling. It's the bowling shot, but we're getting it from behind. So we're going to see the pins.
We had this script that ultimately boils down to a guy that takes one shot and has to bowl a strike. And so we thought all the way through pre-production that we would have to cheat it.
I turn to Spencer and I say, "If he doesn't get a strike, we're not going to be able to use this shot." And he says, "Well, get him to get a strike." And I turn to him and I said, "You better pull a strike." And he said, "Okay." So then he bowls.
You know, the ball rolls and we're thinking, man, that's a pretty freaking good shot.
And the second it touches the pine, I'm like, this is a strike.
And then, of course, all the pins fall.
Just boom, strike. And it was the most perfect movie magic moment you could ever ask for, because you can't write this stuff.
I think ultimately it was the film gods giving us a little gimme.
You can't ask for anything better than what is written in the script, and he delivered it.
To capture that in a one take was pretty spectacular, and it was the only, I think of all of the shots, that was really the only shot where the entire crew was absolutely silent. It was, you know, the biggest project that I've been on, and also the best project that I've been on. And I feel like it was one of the best scripts I've ever done, and the best footage that I've ever captured. And I feel very, very, very grateful. And I feel very, very blessed to have been on this project.
Thank you.
Cheers, guys. Enjoy 300.
Cheers.
Asterisk. Asterisk.